Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, grasshoppers. It's another day of training and preparation for Iceland. We've fallen a little bit behind in our D4 preparation. I do need to put a few days into C4 preparation. Interesting. We're going to go with the exchange Slav for a moment and see what kind of trouble our opponent can get himself into. I promised myself that I would get into this. Rachmanov, Grandmaster Alexander Rachmanov, who also streams, promotes this particular variation. And we're going to continue to expand in the center. We've waited, and now, how much can we wait for? E4, DE4, DE4, knight takes E4, but I think I'm just gonna play E5. We're gonna attempt to blast this center the old-fashioned way. Gambiting a pawn, trying to go after our opponent's light squared weaknesses. Even though I would love to have a knight on e5 for this particular venture. Listen to the music all the time. Let's just get ready. Appropriately enough. Now my opponent has only one pawn in the center, and I have three pawns fighting for the center. This is going to be exciting. Exciting. We could have had it all. By the way, if you've not yet subscribed to the Chess Informant, this stream is powered by Chess Informant, as I am constantly overlooking how much Chess Informant has given me as far as much of my inherent strength over the years. There's a fire starting in my heart. All right, I will let this Adele song go. Normally I would pass on an Adele song because they are so slow and sometimes whiny, but for chess playing it's not appropriate. However, here, all right, so we have a relatively good grip on the center. Matcha Latte Bob offering me a pizza here. I think he's losing a piece, but I don't even know where to begin. But I'm just going to take the piece. Rolling in the deep, you have my heart inside of my head, and you played it to the beat. Did I want to do it that way or this way? Well, I don't have much of a choice here. And I'm going to make your head burn. Think of me in the depths of your despair. Making a home down there is my choice. So how have we accomplished this much? The scars of your love remind. So what is the story here? We managed a big center. My opponent is going for it, it looks like. I'm going to pretend like he's not threatening me. How about that? I do have a little bit of a problem on my hands. Whoa! Gats. I'm in big trouble. I do need to cross and cover as best I can. Alright, and now for something completely irrelevant. Takes, 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 takes. Are in troubles. We're gonna have to look at this game again and see where I let it slip. Bishop c5 is a good move. And I cannot. Interesting. Threatening that. It's got to be an exchange sack. Coordination, everybody. Peace coordination. That's really what it's all about. I need coffee after this. I'm running behind in coffee. Say slicer. Egads. Can't believe that I survived this. Hopefully the music's not too loud. So this was the first time I think I successfully pulled off a I need to interfere with the back rank. I'm not the only one with a weak back rank. He did avoid me taking his queen. Am I getting coffee? We you have 15 players. Four are paused, so I don't want anyone to get a full point by, so we'll do one more game. I have to make up my mind here. What is the most unbeatable? I did want to play. A Dutch defense. Interestingly enough, I was going through an attacking repertoire for white with 1d4. Let's just keep up the pressure the old-fashioned way. Rook to c1. Means that he's not going to be attacking my b7 pawn, which is a good thing. And now for something completely irrelevant. Can I take on f3 first? No. Rook to c8, b6. c4, knight to d4. All right, let's get creative here. I definitely lost a pawn in this deal. I'm gonna have to work my tuchus off if I'm gonna get anything out of it now. And now for something completely different. Wow, he let me do that. That is a spot of craziness. Trying to keep him from getting his pieces out. If at all possible. Good move on his part, really. Sweet. Yeah, I'm in big trouble. Got up and went. You got good news, you're a real good liar. Get the backstage lover, set your pants on fire. Wow. That's so bizarre. F5 was my original intention. Should I have gone for it? I'm sorry, G5 was my original intention. So now, do we have a double attack or don't we? Dark on the street sounds so familiar. So I can't allow E6 with check, so I don't think I have much of a choice in this particular matter. Everybody's watching you. Johnny come lately, the new kid in town. everybody loves. Amazing how much counterplay in a dead lost position Grunfeld can yield, even if you might not have the safer kick. What is he threatening? Is he threatening queen to d4 check? He is. It's a bummer. Just up a pawn, but it's a double pawn and it's a rook's pawn, so it doesn't look like it's doing much. So check, check. How about that for a dead lost position? One of these days I'm gonna have to learn how to play the Grunfeld. One of these days I'm gonna actually study this opening. The Grunfeld plays itself. The Grunfeld speaks for itself. Do not study openings, kids. Save your money. Learn how to checkmate. How are we doing, by the way? Uh-oh, we didn't play. Dudovich. Your rating can only go up in this field. Oh no, Robert FP did not make a move. That means he's banned for 24 hours. 16 players. 3 are paused. I'm gonna pause to get coffee. Whoops. Coffee is a command. Short break. I'll be right back. Short break to get coffee.
Vodka martini. Shaken, not stirred.
As winds set high. As winds said okay. As Win. Thanks for following. Dark Blade said hello. As Win said it is okay. Dark Blade said, what are you referring to? Nor works said hello there.
Thank you.
Dap, late. Said sorry, no words, 123. Dap, late. Said totally not flexing. No words. Said Darkblade 512, no problem, how many points do you have? Darkblade. Said 183k.
Game's still going. It's been a relatively quiet morning here. Good morning, Kingslayer Sloan. Darkblade. No words. Watch time. June 10th is our anniversary. 3-year anniversary, eh?
King Slayer Sloan said 236k. The Warrior said hello.
Well, they're flexing on their channel points. Good morning, The Warrior. For those of you that missed it, I just had the most amazingly bad game in the Grunfeld.
The Warrior said log time meet.
So let's see, as black. So it was here that I decided to mix it up with C4, which loses a pawn, but accomplishes our primary goal of getting out of the opening. And only being down a rook, apparently. We are that much in the hole, according to our erstwhile friend. So anyway, knight takes e5, and of course the thing I was worried about in this position was queen a4 check. Followed by king takes e2 and rook on a to d1.
The Warrior.
However, I was playing black. My opponent plays queen e2 and allows me the slightest of counterplay. Castles bishop to d4, And now I went off on a tangent again. Yes, I should have probably bothered his queen straight away. But I chose to bother his rook, and then bring the other rook to the fore. So everything seems to be good. And then I played this atrocious move, e5, overlooking en passant. When I could just retreat. But why retreat when you can attack? So my opponent helps me out and does not play pawn takes pawn en passant. It would have been devastating to my king and everyone that I know, all of my loved ones. Yowzers. I don't know that I would have survived that one. But instead, my opponent takes and allows me to slow down his castling, bother his queen, get a little loosey-goosey in the center, tag two weaknesses, tag another weakness, and then go for it on these grounds because we have check and we pick up a pawn. And now we're headed in again. And he follows through on his promise to open up my king. So at least we'll both have unsafe kings. I was expecting rook to d2, and I wasn't entirely sure what I was going to do about it aside from queen to c6. Putting pressure on all fronts because I couldn't allow e6 to come with a gain of time. So needless to say, as it turns out, we managed to come in on this side of the board. He tries to stop me. I actually opened up lines against my own king, and I should be completely toasted here. But for whatever reason, I'm not, since I get a lot of counterplay, and even more counterplay. Threatening check, which he doesn't stop. And now we just win a rook. By happenstance, and we turn the game around. That was a nice one. Now, how did I almost lose my first round game? I was dead lost in my first round game as well. So in this particular instance, we were planning on playing the most aggressive line. I chose rook to c1 over e3 because I felt I could get something more on this, and I did. I actually went for it with e4. All of this seems good. Knight to b4. Ah, he had to play e5 straight away. I certainly wouldn't mind this at all. So in any event, it plays knight to b4. It seems like I'm getting a pizza out of the deal. Ah, f takes e4 first. And they still have to play e5. Interesting. So f takes e4 first. And then I can take the knight on a safer square and I'm up in material. As I planned on being. But I was stopped thinking after knight to b4. I went for this, this, and that. I even go for more counterplay on this front, and then this insta-reaction, and I'm up a pawn. How long can I actually keep it? I sort of hung my pawn here, and I go for counterplay again, which I achieve. exchange sacrifice, and he walks right into it. Thank you very much. Now I'm back to winning. What did he have instead? F takes E3.
Nor works. Said Darkblade 512, does he always drive people crazy with random Discord notifications?
Oh no. What are the random Discord notifications? Oh, I have to mute that, don't I? That's what I wanted to do the other day. I do have to mute that. It's the Moobot server you're talking about, right? Let's go back and make sure we're not playing a game.
Said I mean you don't have to, you will just drive people crazy, which is fun.
Which is fun, huh? General channel permissions. Allows members to view this channel by default. Manage channel. Allows member to change this channel's name. Manage permissions. Create invite link. Send messages. So this text channel. There we go. How about that?
No works. Said right click the channel, then set notifications to none.
But that's for individuals, right? I was trying to stop it from notifying everyone automatically. In any event, we'll see. I'm gonna meet. He's got himself a girl and I wanna make her mine. And she's watching him with his eyes. And she's loving with that body, I'm just knowing. And he's holding her in his arms late at night. You know, I wish that I had Jesse's girl. I wish that I had Jesse's girl. Where can I find It's a little late for G3, don't you think? Don't you think it's a little late for G3? Dirty when they start talking cute. I wanna tell her that I love her, but the point is probably moot. Those eyes. She's loving that body, I just know it. Holding her in his arms, living. I don't want to lose a pawn. Let's just be careful. We're just gonna be careful. That like Jesse's girl. Wondering what she don't see in me. I've been funny, I've been cool with the lies. Knight takes, bishop takes, I don't know.
Kingslayer Slorn said no words, 123 lessons from XCOM.
Lessons from XCOM. Driving people crazy. finishing our development for us 101. So far, so good. And now for something completely different. 94. It looks like it's forcing that issue, doesn't it? Queen to g4. Knight takes. Pawn takes. Let's just sack a pawn. What's life for, anyway?
No words. Said Kingslayer Sloan, driving people crazy is my specialty, like making people think something is moving when it's not.
All right, and now for something completely different. Rook takes f2. I don't know. E5. Bishop check. Takes, 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 takes. I do wish to get him on that front as well. For those about to rock, we salute you. About to rock.
No words. Said Kingslayer Sloan, have you praised our Lord and Savior Escom today?
We salute you. For those about to rock. I don't think I have a choice in the matter. And now for something completely extravagant.
Kingslayer Sloan said, no words, 1, 2, 3, I have not soon to be fixed. Nor works. Said good elves, he will take th the light and warmth from us all for ye sins.
those about to rock, we salute you. Oh, I'm playing Ron Hay. Uh-oh. I thought I was playing Nico. That's craziness, folks, that I'm playing Nico. So can I play that? Check. Can I get out of this mess? I don't know if I can get out of this mess. Anybody out there? You just gotta let go. I know what you're trying to do to me.
Kingslayer Sloan said no words. 123 do SA people still HHAVE bottles of water all over the place just in case the water goes too.
We've got an outside past pawn. We better use it. I shouldn't have looked. I should not have noticed that I was playing Ron. Just gotta let go. Even though I was going to play bishop to c6, that was my original intention. It doesn't work because he has bishop a3 at the end, and that looks like it's counterplay. All right, moment of truth, everybody. How does bishop c6 work?
Nor works. Said Kingslayer Sloan in the Cape, yes, they keep water, and in any supermarket there will be 5-liter waters and refill stations.
Am I getting mated? Queen takes, bishop takes, check, queen there. Gotta let go. Did you really care? Did you really care? Yeah, yeah. Am I lost? That's a good question. I seem to be okay. Even though it is extremely, excruciatingly scary. Oh no, I'm not okay. I am not okay. I looked at only Queenie for check. So am I mated? Let's find out. Obviously on King H6, Rook H8 check, I am mated. Yep, you got me. All right, I would like to see this particular position in an analysis board. I feel like right here, could I have played takes, 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 takes. Check there. Rook takes. And now I feel like there's something here. H5 straight away.
King Slayer Sloan said no words. 123. Don't you worry, you guys will be a second world nation any day now.
South Africa slinging. I'm already in trouble. Yeah, King H7 straight away. That's crazy.
No,
right.
Works. Said King Slayer Sloan, wait, they sending us to Venus.
Ark, Ron, you got me good. Ron, you got me good. We're still working on our D4 repertoire today. Knocked me to fourth place. C'est la vie. At least we took it off with a short break. We got our coffee. That's somewhat important. What I need is a Keurig K-Cup sponsor. All right, and we're off. Willing to sacrifice your love. You never take advice. Someday you'll pay.
King Slayer Sloan said no words. 123 to call for you guys, and the power might work.
So now,
Kingslayer's lawn. Said I wonder if bricks will help SA.
It just looks like too much fun to not take at least once.
Kingslayer's lawn. Said a gold-based currency would be great.
You've seen it before, it happens all the time. Closing the door, they leave the world behind. Digging for gold. Throwing away
a fortune and feelings. No words. Said Kingslayer Sloan, nothing can help SA, trust me on that. Kingslayer's lawn. Said no words, 1, 2, 3, I believe in you guys.
What in the world? Yes, I know. Well, that's guarded, that's guarded, and that's guarded. See where he goes. So now takes there. Is there anybody in there? Just not if you can hear me. Is there anyone home? Relax, down. I hear you feeling down. I can ease your pain. Get you on your feet again. Relax. We need some information first. Just the basic facts. Can you show me where it hurts? Do I want to take that at all? And then play rook to d5? What is the ship's smoke on the horizon? I'm really not playing with all of my cards here. Trading these two pawns, allowing his rook to be activated when my knight is perfectly well placed. Got a terrible end game. Do I have any redeeming features here? So he's sacking a pawn. Come on, it's time to go. So we're taking a pawn, he's taking a pawn, but it's in front of his king. The chip smoke on the horizon. I'm gonna check. So now, I am in a spot. Got her gun. Jimmy's got her gun. Whole world's come undone. Yeah, I'm in trouble. Rook G6, Rook G8. It becomes painfully clear how badly I was in that game. Egads. I took one round off, lost to Ron. I ended up in fourth place. C'est la vie, everybody. C'est la vie. Seven watch streak. Must be at an 8 watch streak now. Ron Hay. I have removed Wednesday mornings from my schedule. That way I don't have to fret over billiards night on Tuesday night, getting home at 1 o'clock in the morning and then having to stream at 4 a.m. I've tried it so many times. It doesn't work. Ladies and gentlemen, the power of chess informant. Check out the latest sale on products at the end. Special pricing for our stream. Just for you. Combo books, the parallel series, quite impressive. Complete games, lessons. I love old wine in new bottles as well. If you want lessons from a grandmaster on various parts of the game, old wine in new bottles brings about certain themes that really, really resonate with the traditional strategic player. Being slap happy. Wow, Sugar Chess making a recovery. I'm afraid I'm going to get flappy being slappy. I might get slappy as well.
Try to knock them down. I'm
18 players this morning. Sending out the announcement 15 minutes beforehand.
Said pawn power.
Pawn power, indeed. Good morning, Ron. A proper good morning to you. Good morning. Yeah, I knew I was getting flappy being slappy. Alright, we're gonna go with the default. Is he a real English player? We're gonna find out. Ron is an English player. He's a real Swedish English player. This is a direct hit on third place. If I can overtake him, life will be good. He and Ron are a half a point ahead of me. I've not seen that one before. I think he moved his pawn too many squares, and the b4 square is now weak. Can I play it that way? b6, ab6. Then I really do lose a pawn, yeah? Fine. We'll prepare it. As much as I wanted to play the move b6, ab6, ab6, rook a8, knight a8, knight takes e5, knight takes e5, and then... So this fellow's a real English player. Ye gads. I don't like it.
Nine
so,
raiders
now
from
we're trapped in Fisher's mind,
yes
battling
is
his
back.
Own private
Ilyes
home.
Ilyes is back, is back.
We'll be lost in limbo till our brains turn to scrambled egg.
How are you, Ilyes is back? We need a shout-out for Ilyes is back. Amazing
welcome
tournament to organizer.
Namaste.
Ilyes
is back.
Ryujin.
Said I am back. Ryujin. Said hi.
No, he's working really, really hard. I hesitate on awarding prizes, but I think awarding the prizes to the streamers is the right way to do it. So this is all well and good for the average. Mm-hmm. And now for something completely different. Trying for my d6 square. The e6 square. The b3 square. I don't know, it seems like I'm getting overworked. My opponent is the better player. I'm not going to delude myself on that note. Is this and bones. Moving on. Moving on with some heart. This is going to require a little bit, just a little bit of concentration from our opponent. Queen to b3, knight to d4. Queen to a2, bishop to f7. e3, knight to b4. King h1. King h8. Yep.
Rivujin. Said Barajuda, I like this song.
Indeed. Where are you from, sir? Ryujina.
Ryujin. Said Barracuda.
I am FIDE trainer, national master, Charles MacArthur. I've been around forever. And a day.
Rivujin said, I'm from Morocco.
Oh, that's lovely. One of the truly lovely, exotic places in the world that everyone deserves.
Rivujin said, how about you?
Is he offering me a draw? He is a half a point ahead. So is he playing knight to b5? Check and then takes. Let's throw this check in just because it's here. And now we're not recapturing, right? Knight to b5. Do I have this terrible bishop? It's rather tragic that I have this terrible bishop. Oh! I had to trade queens first. I one of the drawbacks to having a touch screen. Let's see where we went wrong. Because White did have the better game. Let's look at this from our side. So we've managed to return to a normal position here. F4. Einar Gosel. Losing to a 23-45. Knight to B4 right away. Is that true? Knight to B4 right away. Yes. With the idea of knight to D5? I don't think so, but there is a hole on that square that it should be operated on. May need to tuck our king away. Bishop to e8, and now I'm back to being better again. And I missed bishop h5. I was so concentrated on this. Bishop h5. Darn it. And knight on d to e6 to get rid of the other thing. And bishop to c6, fighting for the long diagonal. Oh, I'm so sad. Flappy being slappy. It is a 9-round tournament. Flappy has not yet played. I am from Denver, actually. I don't know if it said that about in my about information. I'm sorry that I didn't actually get your question, because I'm going to type that one out just in case that has it. But I think it had it. I was born in Denver, Colorado. And yes, my first name is John. John Denver died an early and tragic life in a private plane flying across the Rockies. Relatively great singer, songwriter. He was like the Ed Sheeran of his day. If anybody would be John Denver reincarnate, it would have been Ed Sheeran. I don't mind everyone seeing the random channel notifications, but alright, I think I did it. I think I muted that channel. Well, know in a minute. Let's take a look at Crispo and a very tedious endgame. Not easy to win this endgame. Crispo is holding Narata. Unless he falls asleep at the wheel. Sugar Chess King. Interesting. I'm not sure if that's a good idea or not. Two rooks for the queen. Ouch. Queen D2 and it's game over. Queen takes E4 and it's even more game over. Yeah, I was looking at Queen D1, just picking up the rook. Sorry, Ron. What happened here? Our rook got threatened. There was no defense. What happened on the previous move? Rook to E2. Yeah, that's a... Sorry, Ron. That was a spiral and a half. We're still on the D4 track.
Said WH, hats up, John.
How are you, Rogan?
Pegasus SVE. Said KH1 was better, not H3.
Yeah, King H1. Trying to cut defend across the rank. I could see that. Do we want to play the white side of the French? Yeah, I'd rather play the white side of the French than a random Dutch. Whoa, my opponent knows how to play the French. Usually they take on E4, admitting they don't know how to play the French. Is this pawn a weakness? It appears so. Wow. Did I lose a pawn? I guess I did. I lost more than a pawn. I might be two pawns down. On bishop takes d2, I was a little concerned. Ouch. Now I have a lot of work on my hands. A lot of work. I insulted his French defense skills, and he served me up a big bowl of raw. A big bowl of raw. Just say so. I am so lost. Dead lost, ladies and gentlemen. Dead lost. Just the way I like it, obviously. Oh, king takes would have been annoying. Moment of truth. This is the most rating points I will lose all day. Crossing my fingers that that is true.
Kingsley Aslawn said him no Arsenal fan Richie but
can I? And then if G3, am I in Zook? I believe I am.
Kingsley Aslawn said the power of the fish may reside in that man.
Yeah, we can only cross our fingers on that note. We can only cross our fingers on that exact note. Yes. That's a good move. No, that's not what I wanted. I wasn't gonna get it anyway, was I? I need this king on C2 here. Nah, I need this king on C3. Get on with the fascination, the relation, the underlying. Yeah. King takes on F4 was my last hope. Disrespected the man's French. You can only do that if they're Canadian. I don't think he's Canadian. I have a very okay score against him. He doubled his record against me almost. Ay, ay, ay. That was rough. I took that one hard. Don't you wish to be? Must put aside the animation. Get on with fascination. The real relation. The underlying. Eva Aronson, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, Eva Aronson is a Swedish born American chess player. I don't know that I ever met her in person. She must have been very old by the time she reached the United States. She was married to chess player Nina's Aronson. Imagine having the name Ninus. He also moved to the United States. She was never U.S. Women's Champion. I don't mind you coming here. Interesting. And wasting all my time. When you're standing oh so near. Kinda lose my mind. Arsenal fan Richie, how are you, man? Oh, he just invoked the name Arsenal fan Richie. Richie wasn't actually saying anything. I'm no Arsenal fan Richie. Iceland in 13 days. We're getting there. Hopefully Grandmistress Iron will make it to the tournament. Oh, that one took the socks off of me. What was I thinking? What was I thinking? All I have to do is play good chess. Why would I want to change the pawn structure so rapidly the way I did? Robert FP is back. We were in negotiations for training. I was sacrificing my c7 pawn with a double capture on d5 and bishop takes c7. That much I do know. I'm wasting all my time. What am I doing here? And now for something completely different. I don't know. That's wild. Is he trying to give me two pieces for a rook? I do not know. That's interesting. Where's the knight going? Now if you're feeling kind of low about the dues you've been paying, future's coming much slow. And you want to run, but somehow you just keep on saying, can't decide on which way to go. Yeah, 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 I understand about this chance, but I don't care if I get beyond. Keep on living in competition. All I want is to have my peace of mind. Yeah! Whoa. Hope it doesn't take too long. Won't you see there come a day when it won't matter? Come a day when you'll be gone. I understand about indecision. I don't care if I get beyond. People living in competition. All I want is to have my peace of mind. Hark. Sorry, Robert. Good morning, Mad Quick Chess. MQC in the house. We're out of coffee. One round to go. One blunder loses the game? Not true. Not true, actually. It's usually a series of moves that lead up to that blunder that caused the blunder. So far, so good, right? D takes c5 is certainly the most popular line. Any other move allows D takes c4 and C takes d4, and white's the one that should have the isolated queen pawn. Let's go to the lead chess database. Being on the black side of this is definitely a plus. I should just develop my pieces, but I don't want to make life too easy. So I'm trying to create. It looks pretty bad here, actually, at this moment. Looks pretty bad. Rook to d8. Oh, I can't watch. Yeah, the knight was just getting into trouble. It was a whole series of small moves that were leading up to...
Dark Blade said, hello, Sensei. How are you doing today?
I just had a wave of tiredness fall over me. This is not good if I have a lesson in a half an hour. Like, not good. I'm trying to adjust to Reykjavik time. So I got up around 3 o'clock in the morning, give or take, maybe 4.
Dark Blade
on a weekend,
said coffee for the win.
Coffee for the win? I don't have time to go get coffee, do I? Or did I get a full point buy? So let's see, this fellow has 2 minutes each. There are 4 games left. You might be right. Coffee for the win. Let's go for it. And ladies and gentlemen, this stream is powered by Chess Informant. While I'm gone, check out the special pricing. If you can go through those games, even such a simple series such as the Positional Sacrifice series, you will gain immense understanding by playing through those games more than once. I'll
Dark
be back.
Blade said, I'll be watching over here. Go get your coffee.
Thanks. I'm not going to withdraw. I am going to cross my fingers that I can get the coffee and make it back in 2 minutes. whatever reason, we made it. 2 minutes or less. It's also good to stretch the legs. Now that I think about it. Let's see how it goes with Mutakin.
Meth thick chest. Set me tired too.
Yeah, I can imagine. It's even earlier for you. It's 8 o'clock in the morning or so. Crispo? All it really is a switch. You can flip that
Met
switch.
Big chess. Said 913, am about to coach all day Saturday and Sunday.
Nice.
Dap, late. Said I had a question for you, Sensei. Any recommendations for a system to play as black? I am not very satisfied with my French and QGD lines.
Well, I do believe you should mix it up every now and then. Try not to play the same thing all the time. It helps keep you fresh and open to new ideas and tactically
Met,
alert.
Chess. Said Black Lion, perhaps.
Yeah. Ouch, White lost a piece. Ron didn't want to take the free piece. Ron will take the free end game, though. That much is true. Oh, that's torture. See it all around you. Good love and gone bad. Usually it's too late to wake you. Realize what you had. Yeah, no, I think that you can almost choose any opening repertoire based on a really strong player. I would suggest looking at the players that you like and play the openings that they play. That way you get to do two really great things. If you like watching the games of Wesley So or Anish Giri or Aronian,
said any opinions over E6, B6 or the modern.
I mean, which of the strong players that you really like play those systems? Like, for example, let's take a fan-based society. We have role models for our existence. We learn to walk by seeing people walk. We're not going to do something, let's just say, oh, dogs walk on all fours. Let's try that for a while. Let's walk on all fours. Walking on all fours has been a time-honored way of walking.
That's late. Said IBE seen Levy recommend the former and Hikaru plays the latter IT Inc.
Hikaru does play the modern a lot, but mainly because his father played the modern. His father threw a lot of pieces with the modern, that's for sure.
Met Vic Chess. Said Levy has an agenda, he'd be skeptical of advice.
Levy has an agenda. That is true. Well, I got a full 0.5 for the last round. There was no coffee to be concerned about. No coffee run there to be concerned about. Let's take a repertoire book such as one, like Larry Kaufman's repertoire.
That late. Said yeah, which is why I am asking for Sensei's opinion. I trust him more. Met Vic Chess. Said and why you would follow Levy or Hikaru compared to your level. Met Vic Chess. Said but you do you.
I love Larry Kaufman's book, the 2-in-1 book, Repertoire for White and Black. Basically, this book is giving you a very good idea of what to play based on Magnus Carlsen's opening repertoire. I also love to hear it from Grandmaster Joel Benjamin that if I like to play the Nimzo Indian, that I needed to follow that player. If I wanted to play the Budapest, I would follow this player. So, for example, Moskalenko. I was going through Moskalenko's attacking repertoire for White, and he does not give a line against the Dutch, which he's written a few books about. In fact, I'm wondering if I have his book on the Dutch.
Metric Chess said, what's your live or online rating and time control? Darkblade 512.
Darkblade is pretty good. He's a very good player.
Metric Chess said, and why a system trying to build patterns or gain rating or what? Darkblade said, I basically want to try out some new things at this point. Mad Quick Chess, I am 2000 rapid on Lichess.
What do you like to play with White though, Darkblade? I don't recall. I think that you wanted, wanted to be an E4 player, so I would definitely suggest, you know, why not an accelerated dragon type setup and a King's Indian / Grunfeld type setup as black. I ironically, you saw me play the Grunfeld earlier with no knowledge of the opening, and it came out relatively fine. E4 has to be played here. Oh, he's going for that.
Darkblade.
It's all about coordinating.
Said with White, I always play E4, but I am thinking of switching to F4 to again to try out new things.
Ah, then the Dutch. There's actually nothing wrong with the Dutch, except for the fact that its eccentricity makes piece coordination a lot more difficult. Now, I'm not a big fan of passive systems. The French defense is a passive system.
Said, experiment sounds pleasant at the moment, but then main benefit to system would be patterns, so committing one buddy got to 2,200 basically off coal.
Yeah, that's actually a very good solid system. Basically, the Collie Zucker tort. The young Danny Raid actually got to 2,200 with the Collie Zucker tort. And I'm like, to me, it's just so, I mean, it's achieving a result, but it's just such a grind. Like, why would I want to play that way? He's having a tough time coordinating his pieces here.
Said, in 2-2-0 USCFI mean and online blitz much stronger because system helps a lot with blitz.
Yeah, if you're a fast player, you definitely get rewarded. E4 is still possible. And if DE4, then D5 with the main threat. So E4 is still possible.
Darkblade said, my main problem is I can T-memorize too much stuff because my mind is too busy with uni, so I want to try out something new without having to study too much.
Well, like I said, all you need are the ideas behind the openings.
Metric Chess said, Darkblade 512, well, then you sort of missing the point of a system. Metric Chess said, you better off with Scandi. Metric Chess.
That's an easier way of getting a quick amount in. Yep. That is true. Then you can switch to John Bartholomew as your guide for openings at that point. would have still liked to have known what he was going to do on E4.
Met with chess.
I want to see the other
said
side.
Said I got to teach about to be 5 minutes late. See ya.
Matt Quick Chess, have a good one, sir. If that's what it takes me, baby. Wait a minute, I want to see the other side of this coin. That was easy. Wait a minute, 1783. It didn't change. So he's playing at 1783 performance. We're looking at this from a higher rated player's point of view. No matter what we try to do, it's very much a bummer.
It's mate and two.
It's almost mate and two. Together we'll make history. We'll see. We will see. I don't know that there's any way in here for Sugar King. Murata is holding on for dear life. We can just barnacle. Maybe we can't barnacle. Doesn't look good. Could we have barnacled by going back? Posture, ladies and gentlemen, posture. As we bring this tournament to a close. I am going to probably take a 15-minute crash before my lesson. Because it's needed.
You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up, being the way that you are is enough.
Everyone
else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you. Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your head gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile,
whoop,
at the ground,
and
it ain't hard to tell.
We have Ali Reza finishing out this tournament. Sugar King somehow survived that. Oh, well, he was just diving in on poor Narata.
So girl, come on, you got it wrong.
And I've been relegated to outside the podium. But then again, I let it slip versus Ron. And I was very disrespectful to Crispo. Very good, everybody. Nicely done. Are we in the Prague Open with Dina? Is this round two?
Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your head.
Not sure who's doing commentary.
But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard. Pegasus SVE said thanks for all the games.
Ron, cheers and ciao. Yeah, it's time to start studying. So I would once again find a really great player.
Pegasus SVE.
Study Botvinnik if you like the French and the Queen's Gambit. Alright, study Botvinnik and study his openings as black. Basically look at through every Botvinnik win with the black pieces and model Botvinnik's games. You can do a book like starting out with the move by move, the Botvinnik. Or you could get any book on Botvinnik selected games and play through his best games as black. Maybe we'll even try to do a stream on that one. But we'll see. I am torn on where to go from here. Everyone is in Prague right now. Let's see who we have on Lee Chess we're streaming. Let's take a quick peek. This is in Espanol. And then we have, when is the next event? Chronicle Capture. Oh no, we did have a tournament this morning. That's interesting.
Dark Blade said, I think my main problem with the French is it is ill equipped for my tastes. I want to attack, so I just go h6g5.
I usually want to follow the rules of the position, so I can't promise anything like that. Italian, ham for free. Am I not following ham for free? Is that the problem? Taylor Max Music. One Quiet Gamer. Parag. Ah, here's a lovely young lady that we haven't raided in a while. If she allows
said I
us.
Had a great game with it recently. https://lichess.org/l0bwcb8iblack.
All right, I'm gonna check that out. I'm bringing that up in a new window. Oh, this is still a French though. Nicely done. I'm going to post that one into the Discord. If anyone's not already in the Discord, if everyone hasn't already subscribed on YouTube, this is your chance. And if you haven't subscribed to the amazing power of Chess Informant and actually do try to do the work and go through the games, you will be so, so strong. So, so strong in no time. So I need a drink coming up. Thank you everybody for being here. I'm very serious about Vinnick's repertoire with Black. He played the Kitten's Indian, he played the Nimzo Indian, he played the Dutch Defense. But he only played those for certain periods of his life. And those are only the certain periods that you need to study and go over the games of a great player and model their games and material. Cheers and ciao, everyone.